I recall our in our last discussion, you mentioned the refeeding phase was really important for the stem cell proliferation. So after you activate them, you want them to proliferate and continue to grow. And you had mentioned, if I remember correctly, that IGF-1 played a major role in that proliferation because it is, after all, a growth signal, you know.
Yeah, so there is no doubt. We haven't spent too much time on it, but it's pretty obvious and that, you know, you'll need growth factors to do that. So this also makes us think about, for example, the clinical trial, the multiple clinical trials that were done on IGF-1 in cancer that failed, right? And we thought, well, maybe they failed because the IGF-1 was also needed, for example, for the immune system to be built or rebuilt, and in those trials, right? So then the generation of healthy cells is as important as the low IGF-1. So the generation of healthy cells that is IGF-1 dependent is probably as important as the killing of damaged cells that is low IGF-1 dependent,
right.
And the turning on of stem cells, which is also low IGF-1 dependent.
It's low. I thought it was higher. The turning on the stem cell, not turning on, the proliferation of them is high IGF-1. Correct?
Yeah, no, but the turning on, the initial one is low.
Right, low.
Now is the signal
right. To
self renew. You know.
Yeah.
So now you have a small population of stem cells that are just active and standing by. Then probably when IGF-1 goes back up, now they are the ones that are pushed by IGF-1 to proliferate
yeah.
and to differentiate, probably also to differentiate, proliferate and differentiate. Because now you want to rapidly make
new
a lot
cells.
Of, you know, white blood cells, for example, or whatever it is, yeah.
So that's my question about, my question to you then is for the refeeding phase then, do you think then, for example, having some protein would be a little more important because you want protein being essential amino acids, because you want a little more IGF-1 activated during that specific time window? Is that something that you...
Yeah, there is no doubt that when you refeed, you have to have sufficient protein to rebuild. And if you don't, I mean, you really don't have the bricks to rebuild the whatever system you partially broke down. So yeah, protein... And also protein are going to drive the IGF-1. So the whole system, of course, is set up to the sugar and the protein is set up to give the signals to rebuild, which is probably through IGF-1 insulin and IGF-1.